What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel, and welcome to another Pokemon Sword and Shield VGC 2021 Series 10 video. So, the other day, I got a question from someone on Discord, and they were asking, Marcos, why are we seeing so much Swampert now that Series 10 has come out? What's the deal with Swampert? Why is it so good? And that's actually a really interesting question. We've had some tournament results, like, you know, just grassroots tournaments where Swampert has done pretty well. I believe B. Smithy on Twitter and, you know, just he's a Pokemon player, obviously, actually took first in a Nino Pokebros tournament, and he actually had Swampert on his team. Well, I've seen a lot of Swampert in the ladder as well, and I have faced it a few times, and I have used it a bit, so I want to explain to you guys what makes Swampert so valuable in this format, and why it can actually still carve out a niche despite Rillaboom being one of the most used Pokemon in the entire game. So yeah, if you guys enjoy this or learn anything new at any point in this video, do me a favor, leave a like on it, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications, because I bring you daily Pokemon Sword and Shield content, and answer my comment question of the day. What other Pokemon do you see picking up in usage that wasn't quite as good before? Let me know in the comment section down below, and let's shoot for 200 likes once again. But yeah, let's go ahead and start. So Swampert is a very interesting Pokemon. It's got base 100 HP, base 110 attack, 90 defense, 85 special attack, 90 special defense, and 60 speed. All of those stats are absolutely phenomenal. In fact, the speed tier is the same as Incineroar, which means you can actually speed creep Incineroar if you are willing to sacrifice some bulk in exchange for just hitting it first. Now, what's interesting to note is, since we're already comparing it to Incineroar, is it actually has better bulk all around than Incineroar. While Incineroar has 95 HP, 90 defense, and 90 special defense, this guy's rocking out with 100 HP, 90 defense, and 90 special defense. So it has 10 more HP, which makes a huge difference when you're trying to EV this thing to live hits. And it also has access to a ton of tools, being Wide Guard, Yawn, Bulldoze, Icy Wind, Scald. It has so many moves at its disposal that are really useful in a restricted format. Also, the typing itself is really good. Being both water and ground type means you don't have as many weaknesses as most Pokemon, and you resist things like steel moves, you resist fire moves, and most things just hit you for neutral, if anything. And on top of that, you actually end up resisting electric moves, or not resisting, you're completely immune to electric moves, so Regieleki is sort of like not even a problem for a team with Swampert on it. You just switch that thing in and deal with it. Your biggest weakness is going to be Rillaboom, and Rillaboom is easily capable of one-shotting Swampert because it summons grassy terrain and is able to hit it with a stab wood hammer, or even just knock it out with a grassy glide or a lower powered move. It's going to be able to one-shot you because of that times 4 weakness. But what matters more is if you're able to position Swampert on the field and defend it properly, it is able to take on huge threats in the metagame. We're talking about Ho-Oh, we're talking about Zacian, we're talking about Xerneas, we're talking about Incineroar, we're talking about Kyogre even. And I'm going to get into why that is when we get into these three movesets that I have for you. So the first moveset that I have is a Citrus Berry Swampert, and it's a special defensive set. No attack investment whatsoever, but you'll see what it's meant to do in a second here. So this set is running 196 HP, 68 defense, 244 special defense with a careful nature, and the moveset is going to be Wide Guard, High Horsepower, Liquidation, and Yawn. Now, what this moveset's able to do is it's able to block some pretty good or some pretty powerful hits in the metagame, like Water Spout from Kyogre, like Electroweb from Regieleki. Not that Swampert itself cares about the Electroweb, but blocking that move is really important. You can also block Icy Winds or +2 Dazzling Gleams from Xerneas. Now, speaking of Xerneas, this thing's actually able to tank a +2 Moonblast from Xerneas, which is pretty easy considering it has better bulk than Incineroar, and we know Incineroar is able to do that. But it's also able to be 3-hit KO'd by Zacian if it's at +1, so that's an unintimidated Zacian. If it has Intrepid Sword activated, you're going to be 3-hit KO'd due to the Citrus Berry activating at 50% by Sacred Sword. So if you intimidate it, you're living the hit just absolutely. You're doing perfectly fine in the face of Zacian. But if it isn't intimidated, if it does have that +1, you're not really going to care too much because you're going to be able to survive 2 or 3 hits from that thing. So in that matchup, if you're facing off versus Zacian, if you're using this defensive Wide Guard set, then Zacian is actually going to be 2-hit KO'd by your High Horsepower. High Horsepower is doing 61 to 75%, which means that if you're intimidated, if they manage to get an Incineroar on the field, you're not going to be able to 2-hit KO it, or at least it's going to be a roll out of your favor. You're only doing 50% maximum at -1, but it's still really, really good that you're able to resist that Behemoth Blade, you're able to tank the Sacred Sword, and you're able to deal massive damage to it. Let's say you're facing off against a Xerneas. Well, for one, you can block Dazzling Gleam, which is one of the moves they like to click the most. But you're also able to tank a hit from it because of your special defensive investment. And you'll be able to throw off a Yawn either on the turn that it's going to be going for its Geomancy to make it waste its Power Herb, or after it went for the Geomancy to make the opponent want to switch out and voluntarily get rid of those boosts. So that's really good. On top of that, it's actually a really nice matchup versus Incineroar. Even though you're intimidated, Incineroar does not appreciate taking a high horsepower from this thing because of that high base power and the fact that it is a stab move, which means you get a 50% boost off of it. If I actually pull up the calc right now, standard Xerneas checking Incineroar is going to be taking 49% maximum from that. So it's a clean 3-hit KO. So that's really nice. But yeah. Wide Guard is once again very useful for like blocking hits from Kyogre and being able to just have Swampert on your team to support your Pokemon, making sure that you're not really scared of a Water Shot from Kyogre is really useful, especially if you're carrying some Pokemon like Zacian, which, while they are pretty bulky, do not want to take that hit at full power. So yeah, this set is actually really useful for just generally supporting the team, throwing out Yawns, Yawning Zacian, dealing with Zacian itself by just hitting it with its stab high horsepower, throwing off Liquidations, doing whatever it needs to do. It's a very, very good Pokemon. So the other two sets are extremely similar, but they actually allow for Swampert to support the team in a different way while still being able to dish out damage. These sets are actually going to be a physical and special variant of Assault Vest Swampert. So the EV spread for the physical variant is going to be 20 HP, 196 attack, 228 defense, 52 special defense, and 12 speed. Now, the advantage of this set is you actually don't have to run as much special defense, so that means you can invest more into the physical defense, which allows you to naturally only take 49% maximum from Sacred Sword from plus one Zacian, and you don't need the Citrus Berry or anything, which is really, really nice, which also means that you can invest more into your attack stat. This guy actually has an attack stat of 155, where the other Swampert variant had an attack stat of 130. That means your high horsepower will be doing much more damage, and your Liquidation will be doing more damage as well. But the moveset of Flip Turn and Icy Wind actually allows for you to do a couple more things. Icy Wind is great speed control for your team. You could also run Bulldoze if you wanted to, but I think Icy Wind is much better since you don't lower your teammate's speed stat. So you're able to like Icy Wind opposing Zacian, which let your Zacian outspeed, or maybe even like Icy Wind a Regieleki, and then maybe your Zacian can outspeed it at that point. Something like that. Like, you're able to just have great speed control on the field. And with Gothitelle being such a powerful Pokemon in the format, being able to trap in a lot of Pokemon, you can actually lead off with Swampert, scouting for the Gothitelle lead, and then just Flip Turn on it. Get yourself out of there, since Flip Turn actually automatically switches you. But yeah, this guy is going to be able to once again tank a Xerneas Moonblast at plus 2 from Timid Max Special Attack Xerneas. You're taking 49% maximum from a Zacian Sacred Sword. And I believe, I didn't actually calc this, but if you're taking the Moonblast from Xerneas, let me go ahead and check that Kyogre calc for you guys real quick. Kyogre at Max Special Attack with a Modest Nature, let's calc this really quick, I have this in front of me. Clicking Water Spout versus you, since you don't have access to Wide Guard actually, the Water Spout will only be doing 81% maximum from Modest Kyogre, which isn't common. A lot of them are actually running Timid right now. So if we actually calc for Timid Kyogre, they're going to be doing 74% maximum. So this guy is actually able to tank that hit pretty, pretty well and hit it back with a high horsepower, which deals a decent amount of damage to it. If we actually look at the calc right now, this high horsepower from the Swampert set that has the physical Assault Vest is dealing 43% to 51% to a 4 HP Kyogre. So that's actually a lot of damage. It'll decrease the power of that Water Spout. And since so many of them are actually running a Choice Scarf, it's not that bad of a matchup for you at that point. The next variant is basically the same stat spread, but we're actually running a special offensive set, which actually lends itself to dealing better with Incineroar in a couple of ways. This moveset is Earth Power, Icy Wind, Scald, Flip Turn, and the EVs are 20 HP, 228 defense with a Bold Nature, 196 special attack, 52 special defense, and 12 speed. That 12 speed on both of these sets actually allows you to outspeed a lot of Incineroar, since many of them don't invest too much into speed right now, since they're running most of their EVs into their special bulk. But this also allows you to bypass Intimidate, which means that you'll be able to cleanly two-shot a Zacian with Earth Power, no fear of Incineroar switching in and lowering your attack stat, and you're able to run Scald as your main water type move, which will allow you to throw out burns against powerful physical attackers. So yeah, Swampert is able to run so many interesting movesets and tank so many powerful hits that it just carves out a niche in its bulk and its utility. That's the main point of Swampert. Yeah, I think Swampert's actually a really cool addition to this format. I have had a decent amount of experience using it, but I haven't had as much as many people. Like, I haven't run it on a lot of teams. I've ran it on a couple of teams. I like to use it on my current Ho-Oh team, but let me know if you guys want to see some Swampert content in the next couple of days. I will build a team around it if you're interested. But if you guys learned anything new in this video, do me a favor, leave a like on it, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.